make the same mistake this time. We are the children, the last generation. We are the ones they left behind. And I wonder when we're ever gonna change, change. Living under the fear till nothing else remains.
Airport montage. Come on, what other way is I going to start a video of this? We flew into Chicago because you can't fly direct to Kentucky from London. We had a quick changeover. I say quick, it was a couple hours, but you know what it's like when you're moving. Great American cuisine. Then before we knew it, we were on the plane and we were landing into a beautiful sunset in Louisville. JP's 31st state in America. You can climb a mountain, yeah. Didn't really get a chance to show the hotel much, but everything was such a kind of frenzy as we were getting here this night. But we did kick off at the hotel bar with a GTS Brown bottle and Bond. And it was here the night went a bit crazy. We went to Hawks at the recommendation of the bartender at the hotel. Here, the hospitality was unbelievable. The barman gave us a well of 12 and a Calumet 15, just because we were visiting. And look, Jim Beam on tap. By this point we were delirious, it was bedtime. Now you're probably asking yourself, who is this JP fella with a hat and the glasses? Well, let me explain.
This is Dave drinking slalom. Slalom is fucking amazing. 9% brewed in Scotland, don't you fucking know? And JP and Dave are on the fucking sauce.
Slalom! It's fucking brilliant. Brilliant lager.
One pint and it's all downhill.
As you can see, I've known John Paul a long, long time. Coming up 17 years now. This was when we were on tour in Italy with my flatmate's band. We tagged along. He made an impression on that trip. John Paul's now got two loves in life, music and Glasgow Celtic, unfortunately. And he's a man about town. He can be seen on podcasts about Celtic. He runs events at King Tut's in Glasgow. And he's a great laugh. And the reason he ended up here is I text him. I hadn't spoke for a couple of months. And the fates aligned. And aye, here we are, Kentucky.
Good morning from Louisville. It's 6:52. I've got to go and pay the car because I'm street parking. Very tired, as you can hear. Long old day yesterday travelling. And you would have seen the footage go from like nice, crisp to iPhone footage. And that's purely because we just left the camera then and went out for a drink or two and some food. Busy day today.
There she is. That's our wagon, the white wagon. Hi, this is outside the hotel and this is inside it. And it was a 21C Museum Hotel, which is part museum. Art pieces were amazing. Bit of a trip when you come in after a few of the bourbons during the day, but just wonderful. And then the actual hotel bar is quite a famous Louisville bourbon bar. Really cool decor. Proof on main, Louisville. And this was the selection of hotel exclusive bottles. Now, I didn't buy any, and yes, I have absolute regret. So I'm already planning on how do we get back. And it was priced really well. Feel free to pause here. Had to get the weird art museum piece. JP had done the night before. And aye, there's Big Davey. Big Davey just watching downtown as the city was slowly coming into life. Now breakfast, we went to the recommendation again of the bartender from the night before. She said this place was a great wee spot to get some food. So it's at this stage it's like, I think it must be about 8:30 in the morning, 8:15, 8:30. And as we're sitting, as things just keep happening to us on this trip, and the night before was a bit of a trip. I'll explain why, but this one, you might just glimpse someone sitting who John Paul's talking to. I'll explain that in the next video. However, hospitality off the scale, the guy from the kitchen comes out. He's like, here, how about some of this? It's 9 a.m.
Wow. Oh my God, that's so good. That could become an alcoholic.
Well,
you should put it. Juan. Yes, sir. Juan Pablo. Juan. David. Nice to meet you guys. It was a pleasure. Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Juan.
Yeah, you guys enjoy.
Thanks, man. This was at my insistence. I told them it would taste like after 8 minutes. And the first liquor store of the trip. This wasn't the biggest liquor store, but it was just nice to go in and see it, and like, such a difference. The liquor stores in America are so different to the liquor stores off licenses, we call them in the UK. The selection there, I looked at the whiskey selection, the Scotch whiskey, there wasn't any surprises on the shelves. But even now I'm watching this back and I'm thinking, oh, I wish I'd picked up this bottle, and I'd wish I'd maybe bought this instead, or whatever. There's just so much selection. Now do let me know in the comments, what would you have picked up? Those holidays keep catching my eye, and I've heard good stuff about those. There's a couple of old foresters there that I didn't pick up. Again, I regret. I love that truck.
We just hit up Adam's Liquor, spoke to Jesse. Really nice guy. I think a terrible spot to be doing this, right next to the road. We are now jumping in the car and we are heading to Buffalo Trace. Might be a little bit late, so we're going to jump in the freeway and try not to die. We had quite an incident yesterday where that came very close to happen. So aye, here we go.
Act natural, really relaxed, blatantly relaxed here. And we made it. Buffalo Trace Distillery, Frankfort. We had, the tours are free, but they sell out really quick. And this was just the basic tour we went on. Really interesting. Tour guide was fantastic. The site itself is massive. And I know that they do more interesting behind the scenes. I think it's like the hard boots tour. That would have been really good. This was just, it just felt very quick. And you didn't really get to know much about the liquids as such. That was fun when the barrels were rolling down the constant conveyor belt almost of new fresh barrels coming in, and we saw where they filled them up. That was interesting. went into one of the rick houses.
I'm not gonna lie, that smells like pure gasoline.
This was fun. We saw where they bottle Blantons by hand and they write all the labels. So if you've got a bottle of Blantons, it's been here.
It's just easier to get them in the UK.
Then bear in mind, this is free. There's a little tasting at the end that you go to. It's all standard. But what's quite annoying is in the gift shop afterwards, you can't buy any of these except the Buffalo Trace, the Bourbon Cream, and the root beer's fine, but actual whiskey. John Paul's first time trying this, he's getting right into it. He's like, I really like the Weller Special Reserve, that was my favourite. Can I get a bottle of that? And the answer is no. You can't get it at the distillery. This is me desperately trying to get into the vault that's on display. So if you ever complain about where is your allocated bottles, well, they're sitting on shelves in here. There's a couple in there, that Double Eagle Rare. In one of my other videos, that I tried that at the Buffalo Trace pop-up at Christmas. Gift shop was overwhelming, but as I said, the bottles, they have the new Traveller whiskey. I tried it, it was okay. Didn't blow my mind or anything, so I didn't bother picking a bottle up. I did, however, pick up a hat, cigars, even though I don't smoke. Great time though. Buzzing. Now back onto the road, and this was a highlight of the day, to be fair.
Oh my god, we need to come back and take pictures of that. There's like a fucking old mill. It's like all like fucked. Wet? Seriously? Oh my god, this is unreal.
Now when I booked the tickets for this, David very kindly emailed me back and got chatting, and David is the owner, founder, master distiller of Glenns Creek Distillery, and he sat with his, well, it should have been, I thought we were going to be there an hour, 90 minutes, and we were there for 4 hours. So I brought a bottle of the Thompson Brothers single malt to crack open, because we're better than cracking it open than like a craft distillery. He took us behind the scenes, he showed us whole process, fermentation, how they make the mash, how they separate the grains all by hand, how they ferment it, how they distill it. We tried straight from the stills. I'm delighted to say I've got so much more footage from this, and I wouldn't do it justice trying to fit it into this part one. So I'm going to do a separate video just about Glenns Creek and the experience we had there. I was lucky to sit down with David. He chatted and told us a whole experience of how and why and what he does and why it's so important. If you're ever in the vicinity, now it's not far from Castle and Key either, it's about a 15 minute drive from Buffalo Trace, you've got to visit, you've got to get here. Absolutely great experience. This was part of the reason that I came out here. To do this trip, I wanted to learn, I wanted to speak to them, I wanted to understand it, also share a few drams. I left David half a bottle of this to enjoy at his own leisure, and then I had to pick up a couple of the bottles to bring home. The distribution of this is few and far between, so unless you're there or in surrounding states, it's hard pushed to get. But what an experience. until we had to drive home through the worst storm I've ever driven in. That night we went across from the hotel, there was Mussel and Burger Bar, so naturally we had to get some mussels, and then also we had to get some burgers. The lineup of bourbons were great in here, the prices absolutely not, so that's all we saw of them. Before we ended up going to Bardstown Bourbon Company in Louisville, which is just four doors down from the hotel, we didn't know what to expect when we got in here. And we thought the party of sorts that was meant to be happening was going to be in the store. It just wasn't happening there.
We're going there tomorrow. Oh, we're going to the actual... doing everything, yeah.
Well, so if this is part of our origin series. So the origin series is the three whiskeys where it's 100% what we make.
Yep.
So they're all at least 6 years old. This is a six-year-old bottled and bond bourbon. 68% corn, 20% wheat. So it's a wheated bourbon. And 12% malted barley. Our master distiller, Stephen Alley, was the master distiller for Maker's Mark for many years. He's actually been in the business for 53 years. Bourbon Hall of Famer. And some people work for
him. So while there was no people there, it's because they'd all left and they'd all been bussed off. And they told us, right, your turn on the bus. You're heading to a secret location. We're like, okay. And as you can see, there's not many of us on this bus. This must have been the last bus of the night. And it was driving us out to who knows where. We drove for about 25 minutes.
Just getting off the bus. I'm at a secret location.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What? Absolutely metal.
Hold on. Who's this guy? That's no JP. Well, remember the first bourbon we had, the JTS Brown at the hotel bar? Sitting beside us was this guy, Garrett. He was in town to cover the event for Rolling Stone magazine, and it was through him. That's how we got here. Absolute lad.
Different stations. This is the coolest. You're
gonna
love this.
Hi.
Hello. So this is called the Tanzit Experience.
Right.
Or the Booker Effect. Get all of them. Get all of them.
All that pop rock.
Yeah, now you can tap. Yeah, tap it in your mouth. The rest of it.
How good was that?
Was it late?
It's pretty great.
Was it late?
I'll let you experience it yourself. You might be better with words than me. That was intense.
I know.
Now, if it's not clear here what's happening, they had an experiment that was pop rocks into your mouth. Hold the pop rocks, the popping candy. Take the whiskey, put the whiskey in your mouth, swirl it around your mouth with the pop rocks, hold it, and then swallow it. And as you can imagine, it's quite the experience having the alcohol rattling about your gums mixed with the pop rocks.
Whoa, right? I don't want to ever drink anything else ever again. I'm going to exclusively drink that for the rest of my life.
Once in, here we go.
The whole experience, the activation that was put on for this house of Bardstown was unbelievable. And the people that were attending, there was a lot of whiskey influencers, there was a lot of journalists and press, and that's why Garrett was there.
I don't know what's going on, to be honest. It's not what we came here for, and it's everything that's going on. It's fantastic.
We assumed it was just going to be a party. Now, this was all the blends and experiments that Bardstown's been doing, and the head of product development was there, and we were trying different stuff, and it was great. I thought, I'll take everyone for a house tour. Each room was different activation themed, and there was food platters. That one was to do with the Four Square collab, so it was all Caribbean. This one was Goose Island Stout, so the drink was more like almost an espresso martini vibe. You had through here, which was more straight pours. Downstairs, Garrett again, you had the experiment lab, and then you had the main attraction.
I need another rhythm. Okay, okay. Dragon rolls and get on board. We're gonna ride till there ain't no more to go.
I'm trying to use my white ass because I'm trying to use my white ass.
Hereafter, drinks, beer, wine. How do I get in here?
Right, literally right here. Good night, mate. That's right. Pie, tell me.
What?
Pie, tell me.
Pie, ante.
Wow. I can't believe all that just happened.
Great night. Found a speakeasy bar. Then got an Uber with our brand new speakeasy pals, while JP was blasting out some Warren G. We were heading to the next downtown bar, where we ended up finishing the night. Ugh, go on.
Warren G had to regulate. Whoa!
Breathe!